In this video, we're covering the learning theories. So you have classical conditioning, operant conditioning, and also social learning theory, which is also known as social cognitive theory. So you could think of it with either name. Classical conditioning. The names associated with classical conditioning are Pavlov and Watson. Now, Pavlov was a physiologist. He was not a psychologist. He was responsible for the most famous experiment around classical conditioning, Pavlov's dogs, the experiment with the dogs and salivation. So make sure that you're aware of that experiment, that you know the details of it. Also, Watson, who was a psychologist, has an experiment that you need to be aware of, and that is called Little Albert. So make sure that you know all of the details about Little Albert. What is classical conditioning? Simply put, classical conditioning is the conditioning of a reflex or an emotion. Now, when you begin learning about this theory, I really want you to focus on the conditioning of the reflex more so than the conditioning of an emotion. This will help you to get into the details of the theory a little bit more easily, I think. And that is my recommendation to you. So really, classical conditioning is the conditioning of a reflex or of an emotion. For right now, look at Pavlov's experiment particularly and the conditioning of the reflex. When you start to move on and look at Watson's experiment, Little Albert, you can see how they condition an emotion into the child. The vocabulary associated with this theory is stimulus-response connection, unconditioned stimulus, unconditioned response, conditioned stimulus, conditioned response. Make sure you know any additional vocabulary terms for this theory and that you understand how all of the terms fit together within the overarching theory framework. Operant conditioning. Skinner developed this theory. Simply put, operant conditioning is the conditioning of a behavioral response through consequences. Operant conditioning also falls under the umbrella of behaviorism. And according to this theory, there are four conditions that will either strengthen or weaken behavioral responses. You have positive reinforcement, positive punishment, negative reinforcement, and negative punishment. Skinner worked with animals, particularly rats and pigeons, and he used the Skinner box to do a lot of his experiments. Make sure that you familiarize yourself with some of those experiments and you know how the vocabulary terms are used within the experiments. Another important term to remember is schedule of reinforcement. That is very important as well in this theory. Make sure that you know any additional vocabulary terms for the theory and that you understand how the terms fit together within the overarching theory framework. Social learning theory, also known as social cognitive theory, was developed by Albert Bandura. Simply put, we learn by watching others. This theory fits also under the umbrella of behaviorism, but more as an extension. It's not really a true behavioral theory, because in this theory, they consider some of the cognitive elements. As you know, behaviorists do not consider the mind. So it's really more of an extension of behaviorism as opposed to being a true behavioral theory. The famous experiment associated with Bandura's social learning theory is the Bobo doll experiment. Make sure that you know about the Bobo doll experiment. Make sure that you know the vocabulary terms associated with this theory and how they fit together under that main overarching theory framework. To get you started, some of those terms are observational learning, modeling, vicarious reinforcement, and vicarious punishment.